Exceeding grace, make me channel of your exceeding grace.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My dear friends in Christ Jesus, welcome to Exceeding Grace. As we are in the beautiful season of the Pentecost, last week we were reflected upon the beautiful person of the Holy Spirit. And it is possible to have that Spirit-filled life, to be guided, to be controlled by the Holy Spirit. We should seek earnestly. We should desire earnestly to have that Spirit-filled life. One thing is sure, if the Holy Spirit becomes a greater reality in our day-to-day life, our life will be transformed. And if you received the real fire in your life, automatically everyone around you will recognize that change, will recognize that radiance, will recognize that joy, will recognize that radiance of hope and faith in your life. It should be very visible to everyone connected with your life. So let us earnestly ask this great outpouring, this great anointing into our personal life. It is my earnest prayer. It is my sincere prayer for each one of you. Earnestly desire for the infilling of the Holy Spirit into your life. Let us sing and praise and welcome Holy Spirit into our life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Come, Holy Spirit. We need you more and more. We need your supernatural power. We need your beautiful encounter in our life. Oh, Holy Spirit. Oh, Holy Spirit. Oh, Holy Spirit. Come upon my life. Come upon my family. Come upon my nations. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Without you, we are not able to do anything. Holy Spirit, we are so weak. We are so fragile. We need your power. We need your anointing. My dear friends, my dear families, let us together worship, together cry out for the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Come into my life. Come into my heart. Come into my heart. Holy Spirit, I need you. I need you, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, you're all I need. Holy Spirit, your presence I seek. Holy Spirit, my comforter and my friend. Lead me to the heart of Jesus. Holy Spirit, you're all I need. Holy Spirit, your presence I see. Holy Spirit, my comforter and my friend. Lead me to the heart of Jesus. Teach me how to pray like Jesus. Teach me to understand the mysteries of God. Teach me to rise up on my feet if I ever fall into sin. Holy Spirit, come. 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 Spirit, you're all I need. Holy Spirit, your presence I seek. Holy Spirit, my comforter and my friend. Lead me to the heart of Jesus. Come like the showers, Lord, come like the rain. Come with your love to sweep away my pain. Come like the dew to the dryness of my soul. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, you're all I need. Holy Spirit, your presence I seek. Holy Spirit, my comforter and my friend. Lead me to the heart of Jesus. Holy Spirit, you're all I need. Holy Spirit, your presence I see. Holy Spirit, my comforter and my friend. Lead me to the heart of Jesus. Lead me to the heart of Jesus. Holy Spirit, lead me, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Praise you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
My dear friends in Christ Jesus, we need the Holy Spirit. We need His anointing. We need His guidance. We need the supernatural empowerment in order to live a real Christian life. And are you really looking forward to receive that beautiful anointing in your life? I want to encourage each one of you. It is possible to have that spirit-filled life in our life. But it is very, very important to have the right understanding about the person of the Holy Spirit. I have seen many people there. They have the wrong understanding about the Holy Spirit. They think they are not the right persons. They are not the good characters. They are not the prayerful persons. So it is impossible for them to have the anointing of the Holy Spirit. But when we look upon the teachings of the Jesus Christ, Jesus never said, you should be matured, you should be perfect, you should be holy, then I will give my Holy Spirit. Jesus never said, you should have the full understanding of the truth, then I will give my Spirit. Rather, Jesus said, when the Holy Spirit comes, He will guide you into the fullness of the truth. My Paraclete, He will come and He will teach and remind everything. And through the power of the Holy Spirit, you are able to do everything. Jesus never said, you should be my witnesses. You should be my great disciples. Then, because of that, I will give my Spirit, my Holy Spirit to you. Rather, Jesus said, when the Holy Spirit comes, you wait for the Holy Spirit and receive the power. Then you will have the real life, then you will become the witnesses for my gospel. So, my dear friends in Christ Jesus, my dear brother, my dear sister in Christ Jesus, you should have the real understanding about the person of the Holy Spirit. He is doing everything. Only through the Holy Spirit we are able to live a spirit-filled life, an anointed life, a holy life, a life always giving glory to the Lord. Only through the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is doing everything. Hallelujah. And you should have the deep faith in your heart. It is possible to live that spirit-filled life. The hemorrhage woman, she believed, if I could touch the garments of Jesus Christ, definitely I am going to receive the healing. The same way, in this season, in this Pentecost season, as we are declaring, fasting, as we are praying so many ways, we should have the deeper understanding and deeper faith. As a child of God, I am desiring for the infilling of the Holy Spirit. It is possible for me to live that life in my ordinary situations. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us go through some of the beautiful scriptures, and we are going to meet some beautiful characters, all of them filled with the fire of the Holy Spirit. All of them filled with the Holy Spirit and lived a remarkable life. Book of Exodus chapter 31 verses 3. There we see one of the beautiful character, Bezalel. The word of God is teaching us, I have filled him with the divine spirit, with ability, intelligence, and knowledge in every kind of craft. Word of God is teaching us, heaven has blessed a person with every virtues, every charisms, every anointing upon a person, and he was filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Now we come to the New Testament. We will see many, many great characters. Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, verse 1. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the Word of God teaching us, Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. So Jesus Christ was full of the Holy Spirit. It is possible to have the infilling of the Holy Spirit in our life. Again, just think about the character of John the Baptist. The Word of God is teaching us, Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verse 15, even before his birth, he will be filled with the Holy Spirit. You see the term, filled with the Holy Spirit. Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verse 41, when Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. John the Baptist was filled with the Holy Spirit. Jesus Christ was filled with the Holy Spirit. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Mama Mary was filled with the Holy Spirit. My dear friends, every character, it is possible. It is possible to have that spirit-filled life. Again, Word of God, Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verse 67. There we find the beautiful character of Zechariah. Then his father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke this prophecy. So it doesn't matter which profession you are. Are you religious? Whether you are a priest? Whether you are a lay missionary? Whether you are a housewife? You can have the Holy Spirit in your life. Let us carry on. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verse 4. On the Pentecost day, thousands of people gathered in Jerusalem, and the Word of God is teaching us, all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit. All of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit, and they began to speak in different languages. So my dear friends, in this Pentecost season, as we are approaching for the Feast of Pentecost, it is possible for me and you to receive this great fire in our life. Hallelujah. We should believe, we should pray, we should seek, we should wait, and we should be possessed by the power of the Holy Spirit. Then the world will see a new person, a new creation within ourselves. It will be tangible. It will be visible. Everyone around us will ask, what happened to this person? What happened to Dad? What happened to Mom? A clear, visible transformation will take place. People will see a new joy, a new hope, a new anointing in our way of life, in our day-to-day life. People may be able to see the radiance of joy, the radiance of prayer, the radiance of zeal in our day-to-day life. Only one reason: we are filled by the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah! 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 You think about any person, any character, all of them received the power, received the fire, then things are getting changed. My dear family, we need this deep encounter with the Holy Spirit. As we carry on, Acts of the Apostles, chapter 4, verse 8, then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, Peter was addressing the people with the fire of the Holy Spirit, with the power of the Holy Spirit. It doesn't matter the past life of Peter. It doesn't matter the failures happened in the life of St. Peter. But now we are seeing a new Peter. A new Peter with great courage, great wisdom, great understanding, great power, standing in front of the Jewish people, standing in front of the foreign people, and declaring the gospel and telling them Jesus Christ is Lord, and declaring them there is no other name other than the name of Jesus Christ for the salvation of the mankind. And as he preaching, as he declaring, the Holy Spirit is fell upon the people. Everyone who received, who listened to the words of St. Peter, they are able to receive the Holy Spirit in their life. This is significant. This is marvelous. This is beautiful. This change, this anointing, we need in our life. So earnestly desire for the Holy Spirit. The same Holy Spirit used St. Peter and St. Paul. He wants to use each one of us for the greater glory of the Lord. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! My dear friends, so it is very, very important to have this deeper understanding. And we have to pray without ceasing. We have to pray with the full of our heart to be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. When we read the Acts of the Apostles, we will see great characters, all of them filled with the power of the Holy Spirit on the Pentecost day. Peter and Paul and all the disciples were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Then again, when we go to Acts of the Apostles, chapter 6, verses 3 and 5, there we see the disciples are going to select deacons in order to support the community. And what about the remarkable nature of these seven men? All of them filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. All of them filled with the wisdom and prayer. That was their character. These seven men filled with the wisdom and the power of the Holy Spirit. Again, when we continuing Acts of the Apostles, chapter 7, verse 55, in the midst of all the troubles and suffering, even in the face of death, the word of God is teaching us Saint Stephen was filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Filled with the Holy Spirit, he gazed in heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. This was the vision Saint Stephen received in his life.
filled with the power of the Holy Spirit and looking at heaven and seeing Jesus Christ. So my dear friends, it doesn't matter whether you are healthy or sick. It doesn't matter whether you are persecuted. It doesn't matter whether you are neglected, ignored, abandoned by your dear ones. It doesn't matter whether you are uneducated. It doesn't matter your qualifications. If you are a genuine Christian, if you are a genuine person in Christ Jesus, and if you seek to live for the kingdom of God, definitely you are able to receive this Holy Spirit in your life. You are able to live this Spirit-filled life in our common situations. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It is my dream. It is my vision. It is my prayer in every single person on this planet. Especially every Christian has to be filled by the power of the Holy Spirit. You think about a prayer community. 10 people, 50 people, 100 people, all of them filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. You think about a parish community, 50 families, 100 families, 500 families, all of them filled by the power of the Holy Spirit. You think about a religious community. Maybe there are 100 sisters, maybe 1,000 religious Catholic nuns, all of them filled by the power of the Holy Spirit. My dear friends, let us dream about all our congregations. We have many, many blessed congregations and many, many anointed priests. Think about all of them filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. All of them is able to demonstrate the power and the charism of the Holy Spirit for the common good of the faithful. The world will see the beauty of Christianity. The world will see the miracles and wonders and signs. My dear friends, it is very, very important. We should have the deeper dream. We should have the greater vision about our church, our parish communities, and our families. We should dream about the families and communities and the entire church filled by the power of the Holy Spirit. Again, Acts of the Apostles, chapter 11, there we see the beautiful character, the person of Barnabas. What the word of God is teaching, he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith. Acts 11 verses 20 to 24. A person full of the Holy Spirit. A person filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. A person is able to guide many, many people into God's kingdom. A person is a remarkable instrument to bless each and every person. To give comfort. To give anointing. To give encouragement to others. Think about, what about your character? Are you a good person? Are you a person filled by the Holy Spirit? Are you able to encourage others, help others, guide others into the fullness of truth? Let us pray. Let us ask, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, we need you more and more. Again, Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, verse 9. Saul, also known as Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked intently at him. Paul was filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. There is another beautiful scripture. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, verses 52. And the disciples were filled with joy and with the Holy Spirit. Disciples were filled with joy and the power of the Holy Spirit. My dear families, we are going to pray right now. If you are able, stand up in the presence of the Lord. If you are able, open up your arms before the Lord. And like a little child, cry out for the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Offer everything, your weaknesses, your emptiness, your struggles, your confusions, everything into the presence of the Holy Spirit and earnestly cry out, Holy Spirit, I need your divine power. Holy Spirit, I need your divine grace. Holy Spirit, I need your divine understanding. I am so poor in spirit. Holy Spirit, come upon me. Holy Spirit, help me. Holy Spirit, teach me to pray. Holy Spirit, guide me into holiness. Mold me. Fill me. Anoint. Oh, Holy Spirit of God, I want to love Jesus more and more. I want to live a holy life. I want to live a spirit-filled life. Come upon me, Holy Spirit. Remove everything which is not suitable for you. Remove everything. Sanctify me and fill me with your fire. Shall we pray together? Shall we pray together? In this moment, as you are praying, as you are lifting your hands to heaven, believe the power of the Holy Spirit may come upon you. Believe the Holy Spirit is going to change and transform your entire life for the glory of Jesus Christ. Shall we praise together? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Abba Father, I pray in Jesus' mighty name. All those who are watching, all those who are listening to the word of God right now may be filled by the fire of the Holy Spirit. They may have a new life in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Be touched by the power. Be touched by the fire of the Holy Spirit. Be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus.